Hey, hello guys. Would you like to learn how to design these abstract gradients that you're going to see in the screen right now? Just stay in this video, because I'm going to teach you how. We're going to start by creating a file in 1920 by 1080. We're just going to click create. I just name it gradient. And we're going to start with a curve pen tool. It's the one that is right here, specifically curvative pen tool, just to correct myself. And I'm going to start making some abstract shapes that are going to go right here on top of the canvas. I'm just gonna click and make them straight like that. Yes, this one shape right here, a few clicks. When I double click, it makes the shape straight. That's why I'm double clicking the ends of the shape real quickly, right there. This will give us our first shape in particular. This one is gonna have a different color than the one that is assigned right now. We select the curvative pen tool again. Here, we're gonna change the gradient color that it has right now. And I'm gonna select the lighter color to be this specific color that I have right here. Is if you can see, it's 84A4FF. I'm gonna press okay. And then I'm gonna go to the different color, which is the one in the other end of the gradient, full white. Let me go right here, that's FFFF three times, so press OK. And we're gonna try to inverse that. I just wanna change a little bit of the angle, so kind of it goes across the top of it. We're gonna make another shape right underneath that. This one is gonna go from around here, kind of, let's say around here, and it's gonna go all the way to the top, kind of where this meets over here. And just create the shape, close this shape, double clicking here, then we close the shape and we double click just to make sure that it keeps it straight. This one, we're gonna do the same thing with the fill. I just wanna make it lighter at the top and that will work perfectly right now. And I'm gonna make another shape with a curvative pen tool right here, kind of like around here. It's gonna go from here, I would say all the way from here till here. It's gonna be like kind of like a corner shape. This is gonna go around here. And this last shape is gonna have a different color than the other ones. I'm gonna start with a lighter kind of pinkish color for this one. I'm gonna select the curvative pen tool one more time. And I'm gonna do the light pink color on this one. And then the other one is gonna be kind of like a yellowish color. It's to blend it with another shape that I'm just gonna make in a second. I'm gonna select this shape again, press okay. And this shape needs to be on top of the other shape so we can kind of see it. I'm gonna select here. I'm gonna reduce the opacity of this to kind of zero or really low. Just gonna flip this and bring this one a little further just to make it. What we're trying to look for this is create some sort of repetition to create a little bit more harmony in the composition. I'm gonna create now a kind of like a different shape to divide this. It's gonna be kind of like this, and then it's gonna curve like that. And go all the way to the top. Close like that. And this one is going to have a complete different color to the ones that we just made. And it's going to be kind of like an orange, if you may say. I'm going to select right now an orange color. It's going to be like, let me see right here. Double clicking it and it's FC100 and okay. The other color is going to be like a darker, deeper yellowish color, kind of orange as well. Let's see right here. I'm just going to go in this section right here. I'm changing the color of this part of the shape. We're going to increase the opacity of this to 100%, bring it to the back. And then I'm just going to make it a little darker than what it is right now, darker and deeper there, and bring it all the way to the edges. Make this one a little kind of lighter as well. It's gonna, yeah, I'm gonna want it to be darker at the bottom and okay, lighter at the, that's perfect. Now we have these shapes that we need to start doing something with them, but I want to add the backgrounds as well first. We're gonna go to the adjustment and layer section, which is at the end of the layers panel. And here we're gonna select a gradient. And this gradient is gonna be a blue color. And this color is gonna be this blue that we have right here. It's 0016FF. We're gonna press okay to that. And the other color is gonna be the darker or lighter version of that same blue. Let's see, maybe B3C2FF, we press okay. Increase that opacity to 100%. Okay again, and we're gonna start moving it. So the blue comes from the corner, the top of the layer, and we're just gonna increase the scale. I'm gonna increase that scale to blend them a little better. Kind of like 92 sound, looks good. Press okay, and this one's gonna go all the way to the back of the composition that we have right now. If I select the gradient tool, I'm gonna be able to play with it a little better. What I would like to try to do maybe is to make it a, there you go, this type of radial gradient that I can play with it a little better. That way it just comes from the top of the design and it's less intrusive. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna go to the gradient again and we're gonna add another gradient. It's gonna be like a pink gradient. I have it right here already saved and it's gonna be this color FFD. It's FFD1FF. Press okay, press okay again. And then we click okay again. And then we're gonna have this one coming from this side. This one is gonna be on top of these two layers that are right here, but underneath the these two. So we have these two shapes. So we have the orange one and the one that is kind of like a blend between the two, between the pink and the orange. And then we have the pink going behind everything. Here's where it comes with the fun part of the design itself. It's gonna start adding blurs to make the kind of gradients happen and make them look really nice. Let's start with the shape number one. In this one, we're gonna go to the filter. We're gonna go to the blur gallery and we're gonna do with a tilt shift, convert to smart object. And here with the tilt shift, what we're gonna do is just select this part right here and we're gonna tilt it a little and then we're gonna increase the blur. And we're gonna start tilting it until we see, there we go. You see how it starts just making the blur from a specific angle of it. I just want to have this a specific part of the gradient when it starts just kind of separating, so we end up not having something, you know, super noticeable, kind of like that. We're gonna press okay and then we have the first one, and we're gonna do the same thing with the second one that we have right here, the shape two. We're gonna go to the filter, we're gonna go to the blur gallery, and then we're gonna select the tilt shift one more time, convert to smart object, that's okay. And here we place it kind of around the end. We increase the blur a little bit. And that's a little too much. Let's do 81 is fine. And then we just start moving it a little away from it till we get that blur going on over there. Press okay. In this first shape that we have right here, one thing I would like to do is press command J and then take the shape and drag it down a little bit. Press enter. And I'm going to do a color overlay for this and make him like a little darker version of the same color that is right here. I would select like a darker tone of the original color, press okay, and press okay again. And I'm gonna take the same original shape, press command J and put it on top of the layer that we already have. I'm gonna press command T to transform it and bring it in between the layers, kind of like that, just to close it. I'm just trying to create some depth in between the layers. Press okay. I'm trying to make it a little simpler. And then between these two layers, what I'm gonna do is, you know, this one that is in between, I'm gonna go to the filter, we're gonna go to the blur, we're gonna add a Gaussian blur, so that way we have it like a way that it adds a little bit more dimension to the design itself. And we're gonna select these two layers that we have right here, the one that is on top and underneath it. Press command J, command T, press okay. And we're just gonna duplicate that and try to extend it in a way. I know it doesn't convince you a little bit at the beginning, but when we do it, it's gonna look better. Press enter. We're gonna group these two layers. We're gonna add a little bit of a layer mask on top of them. We're gonna press B to create a brush. And I'm gonna do is just gonna create a fade. I'm gonna fade them a little bit, reduce the opacity of them, because I'm just trying to create some depth with what I'm doing right here. Press B to start just blurring the ends of it. Gonna be a little shorter than the other one. And these two, we're gonna group them as well. I'm just gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna create a layer mask and then just blur the ends of it. And then the original one that we have right here, I'm just gonna add a little bit of a Gaussian blur as well, just to make it blend a little better with whatever is going on in the background there. But it's gonna be subtle, like let's do like 2%. Press okay, just to make it, I'm just trying to add a little bit more dimension to the design itself. And then with this one, this shape that we just created that's supposed to blend the orange and the pink, what we're gonna do is gonna go to the filter, blur gallery, you already know, and we're gonna do another tilt shift, convert to smart object. And here, I'm just gonna tilt it a little this way, bring it down and then increase that blend. Press okay. We have this shape a little blended with that one, and this one is going to be the same thing, filter, blur gallery. And this one I'm going to do like an iris blur, convert to smart object, and I'm going to increase that blur kind of like that. That's perfect. I'm going to press okay and we're going to have this entire shape together. I'm going to select all the layers and I'm going to group them. I'm going to press command J just to have this one as a backup in case I do any destructive editing to the original one. It's going to call it backup. And in the original one that we have right here, my gradient, I'm just gonna convert this one into smart object, play a little bit with the hue and saturation. I'm gonna saturate it a little more, make it a little more alive. I'm gonna just press, I'm pressing option right now just to put it to mark with the one that is right there. And the next step will be to go into the filter, and we're gonna go to the filter gallery, and here we're gonna add a little bit of noise to the design itself. Let's change the intensity to like 16. That'll be perfect. Press okay, and this will leave us with our final design. I think it looks really nice and you can create these awesome gradients that you see in the screen right now. If you feel like you learned something new, just give it a like. That'll help me a lot. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.